Hello students, how are you? Welcome back to my YouTube channel Physics Insight. Today in this video we are going to discuss a new concept, that is motion in vertical circle. So students, let me tell you first what kind of motion is called motion in vertical circle. In order to understand this, let's take a simple example. Say a person is holding a bucket full of water and then he tries to move it in a vertical circle like this. Now you will be surprised to see that when person is moving a bucket with a certain velocity, the bucket crosses the highest point of this vertical circular path without spilling the water. Moreover, the bucket didn't fall down. Today we will evaluate the minimum velocity required by a particle to execute the motion in vertical circle. So let's evaluate it, students. Suppose a particle of mass m is constrained with a rope to this point O with rope of length small r. Say it has been released in this direction with velocity u such that it executes a vertical motion. Now this particle is tied with a string, okay, we indicate it with a black line. Now say tension t is acting in the string towards the center. Now after time t, this particle from location l reaches at point p. This l is the lowest location of the particle in this path. And after time t, it reaches at point P, and at this moment the particle is having velocity v. Now in time t, the particle has covered angular displacement theta. If particle has mass m, then weight of the particle will act downward. Now this weight will be resolved into two components. One is base component, another one is vertical component. Now say this angle be theta, as these two are the parallel lines and this is transversal, so according to corresponding angles this angle will be again theta. Now this component of weight will be mg cos theta and this component of weight will be mg sin theta. Now we can clearly observe that the motion in vertical circle is not a uniform circular motion. Why? Because in this vertical motion the velocity of particle at every point will be different, okay. So uniform motion is a motion in which the particle moves with the constant velocity. Since here the velocity is not constant, so we will not consider motion in vertical circle as a uniform motion, okay. So motion in vertical circle is a non-uniform motion. Now we draw a reference line from where the motion has started. From this reference line the particle is at height h. If we draw perpendicular from point P on this length of rope, say we name it as point Q, then this length OQ will be small r minus h. Also the centrifugal force acts outward. We are not talking about centripetal force. Centripetal force is a net force acting on the particle which binds it towards the center, okay. So we are talking about centrifugal force. In reality both the forces have same magnitude, okay, that is mv square upon r. R is the radius of path in which the particle is moving. So now centrifugal force plus mg cos theta balances the tension t. Now centrifugal force is having the value mv square upon small r plus mg cos theta is equals to t. So this is the length of rope whose length is equal to small r, okay. So now from this right angle triangle OQP we can easily evaluate the cos theta. Now cos theta comes out to be base upon hypotenuse. Now the value of base is r minus h in this triangle. Now the value of base is r minus h and hypotenuse is r. So now we will substitute the value of this cos theta in this equation and then we will see the modified equation of tension. It comes out to be mv square upon r plus mg r minus h upon small r is equal to t. Now we term this equation as equation 1. Since only the initial velocity is known to us, since we know the value of initial velocity with which we have projected the particle, now we will evaluate the velocity of particle at point P, that is v. Now by law of conservation of energy, the energy possessed by the particle at every location in this circle is same, okay. So now the energy possessed by the particle at location L will be equal to the total energy possessed by the particle at point P. Now the total energy possessed by the particle at location L is only half mu square, as there is no height of particle at location L, so only kinetic energy will be there. Okay, now at point P, both kinetic energy as well as potential energy will be there. Now we can see, now the particle is h distance away from the reference line and it is having velocity v. So the total energy possessed by the particle is half mv square plus mgh. Now cancelling m both sides, we get half u square is equals to half v square plus gh. By multiplying 2 on both sides, we will get u square is equals to v square plus 2gh. Now we are going to evaluate the value of v. So the value of v come out to be u square minus 2gh is equals to v. And we will substitute the value of this v square in equation 1 and then we will see what we get the value of tension. See, T comes out to be mg r minus h upon r plus m upon r. Now we will substitute the v square as u square minus 2gh. Here m upon r is common, so we get gr minus gh plus u square minus 2gh. It comes out to be m upon r. See, this minus gh and minus 2gh, it will give you minus 3gh. So the equation comes out to be u square minus 3gh plus gr. Now this is the value of tension acting in the string at point P. Now see, this point L is the lowest point of this circular path and this point H is the highest point of this circular path. Now we are going to evaluate the value of tension at this highest point and the value of tension in the string at this lowest point. Okay. So the general equation of tension at point P we have evaluated as T is equals to m upon r u square minus 3gh plus gr. Okay. At lowest point, see, at this lowest point L, the value of this h is 0. So the tension at lowest string comes out to be TL is equals to m upon r u square plus gr. We will evaluate the tension at the highest point H. If the body is at highest point, then the value of H comes out to be 2R. Now we will substitute the value of this H, 2R, in the equation of tension. We will get TH as m upon r u square minus 5gr. This is the tension acting in the string at highest point and this is the tension acting in the string at lowest point. Now see, this is the evaluated value of TH and TL. Now we are going to evaluate the relation between these. Now see, if we subtract TH from TL, what will happen? You will get this u square will cancel out. You will get m into 6gr upon r. These r will again cancel out. So the difference between these two tensions is 6g. Okay. So one more thing I want to share with you, that if the tension is positive, then the particle will follow the circular path. If value of T becomes 0 or negative, then it can follow any path. See, if we are going up, after this point the value of tension will start reducing. At this lowermost point, the tension acting in the string will be maximum. Now see, if the particle is executing the motion in vertical circle, then at this point H, the tension should be greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, what will happen? The particle will fall down and it will not move in circular path. Okay. So now if the particle is executing motion in vertical circle, then TH should be greater than or equal to 0. Now what is the value of TH? See, from here, m upon r u square minus 5gr. So it is u square minus 5gr is greater than or equal to 0. and automatically u is greater than equal to root 5 gr. Now this is how you have evaluated the value of u. Now we will evaluate the value of v. Now we will substitute the value of u in equation A in order to evaluate the velocity of particle at point P. Now see, this is the equation. From A we get v is equals to root u square minus 2gh, okay, and the value of u we have evaluated equal to root 5gr. So u square will be 5gr minus 2gh. So now this will be the instantaneous value of velocity v. So you can evaluate this velocity at any point. So now using this formula you can evaluate the final velocity of particle. So now using this formula you can evaluate the value of instantaneous velocity at any point in this vertical circle, okay. So now I wish to evaluate the value of this v at point M, at this point M, okay. So now what will be the value of h? The value of h will be exactly equal to small r. Now at point M h becomes r. So what will happen? Your v comes out to be root 5 gr minus 2 gr, or you can say root 3 gr. So this will be the value of v at point P. So this is the value of v root 3 gr at point M. So I hope it is clear to you that how will you evaluate the instantaneous velocity v, okay. Now say if we wish to evaluate the value of this instantaneous velocity at the highest point h, then you can clearly see the value of this h will be 2r. Now at point h the value of small h will be 2r, and using this equation the instantaneous velocity at of particle at highest point will be, this was at point M, now at point H it will be root 5 gr minus 2g into 2r, which is equal to root gr, okay. So this will be the instantaneous velocity of particle at highest point, which is root gr. Now we are just going to evaluate the energy of particle at lowest point and at the highest point. If we wish to evaluate energy at lowest point, now at lowest point what is the value of energy? See, at lowest point there is no potential energy, so only half mv square will be there. So energy at lowest point is half m u square, and the value of u we have evaluated as 5 gr, as u is equals to root 5 gr, okay. So the value of u square comes out to be 5 gr, and automatically the total energy associated by the particle at lowest point is 5 by 2 mgr, okay. Similarly we can evaluate energy at highest point. Now energy at highest point will have both kinetic energy as well as potential energy. See, as at the highest point the particle is at some height h, moreover it will have some instantaneous velocity v. Now what will be the value? It will be half m v h square plus m g into h. Now what will be the value of h? It will be 2r. Now it will be half m. Now the velocity at maximum height will be, now we have evaluated v h as under root g r, so it will be g r, as VH comes out to be root GR, and then VH square will be GR, so it comes out to be MG into 2R, and automatically it will be MGR by 2 plus 2MGR, so it comes out to be 5MGR by 2. So that's all students, this is how we have evaluated tension at highest point, tension at lowest point, instantaneous velocity at highest point and velocity at lowest point. Along with that, energy at highest point and energy at lowest point we have evaluated in this. So students, if you are having any query in this concept, you can ask me that in the comment section, and keep supporting us by liking and sharing our content, and do not forget to subscribe our channel. See you again students in the next concept, in the next video. Till then, God bless you everyone.